Hi, and welcome to our series on creating a video project using free web-based video editing software. My name is Mike Benson. In our previous video, we explored the editing process. In this video, which is the last of the series, we will add text and transitions in addition to working with audio and video files. We will also learn about exporting a video so that it can be uploaded to a service like YouTube. To add a title, you select the text button here. Text can be a title, a heading that appears over a clip, or as rolling credits. Clipchamp includes a variety of pre-formatted options that you can edit. If you hover your cursor over the option, you can see a preview. I would like to add a simple title, so I'm going to scroll down and select the large heading option. To add it to the project, I will drag it to the timeline. The text clip will appear on a new track. I want to move the text clip to the beginning of the video. If you find it difficult to move the text clip, zoom into the area. This will make it easier to more accurately place your text clip. To add your text, select the clip and go to the text menu. A drop-down will appear where you add your text. Since this is a title, I'm adding the beach. This looks pretty good, but I want the text to not appear over the image. To make this change, I'm going to add a black background to the beginning of the video. Once you do this, you might need to make minor adjustments to the placement of your other clips. If you make a mistake, you can use the undo button to revert back. Let's take a look at what we have. Great. Now we need to add transitions between each clip. Transitions are used to join clips, making the video more polished. To add a transition, click the transition button. If you hover your cursor over the transition, you can see the transition's effect. Once you find an appropriate transition, drag it between the two clips on your timeline. The small gray icon will appear. Let's zoom in to get a closer look. We'll also add more transitions. If you select the transition icon, a window will appear where you can select a different transition, adjust the duration, or delete it. Let's play the video to see how it looks. As you can see, the photos don't fill the entire screen. We can fix this by selecting the photo and going to the Transform menu to select Crop to Fill. Let's play the video one more time. This looks much better, but I'd like to reduce the volume of the audio. To do that, select the audio file and go to the volume menu. We'll reduce the audio to about 35%. We'll also select the fade menu to have the audio gradually fade in. These options are also available for video clips that have audio. After you have added all your transitions, made all the adjustments to your photos, videos, and audio files, and also added your credits to the end of your video, you can export your creation using this button. Once selected, a window will open showing the available resolutions. The selected option is 480 pixels, which is also currently the default definition for all YouTube videos. In Clipchamp, the starred options are only available in the premium versions of the software. So if you want to export at 720 or 1080, you will need to upgrade. Once you select the continue button, your video will start to process. This will take some time to finish, so you might want to take a break. Once the video has stopped processing, you can download it to your computer or your Google Drive, or you can upload it directly to your YouTube channel. As we have seen, free web-based video editing software such as Clipchamp is a great option to use to create your video project. Depending on your internet speed, the software can be a little slow, but as we have seen, the software does a great job. It offers lots of options and it's easy to use and easy to learn. Of course, a major benefit of this type of software is that it's free, and you can use it on any computer with internet access. This gives you a lot of flexibility to create personal and course-related projects. We hope this series has helped you with your video project. If you need assistance with your creative project or research, please let us know here at the Rowan University Libraries. We're happy to help in any way we can. Thanks for watching.